All right, so this week I wanted to talk to you about using thick paint because I feel like I just see so many beginners just not using thick enough paint. And I tell them to use thick paint and they still don't use thick paint. And I know that it can seem scary because you feel like you don't have a grip on oil paints as it is. And here I am asking you to just slap on more paint onto your canvas and you feel like you can't even handle the paint that's on it right now. I know I sound crazy, but just hear me out. Hi, welcome to Paint Coach. I'm Chris Fornitero here to help simplify oil painting so you can get better faster. All right, before we jump on in, please, if you like this video, if you like this channel, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. It really helps the channel grow. If you're looking for full painting video tutorials, I do have those. They are on my Patreon page, which is linked in the description below. Also, I am coming out with a Foundations of Oil Painting course. It's unlike anything I've done before. It's gonna be awesome. And if you wanna get notified when that course comes out, in the description below, click on the link to get my shortcut to color mixing guide. It's a short 10-minute video where I show you how to mix up any color using the primaries and white. When you sign up to get that video, you automatically sign up to get the Paint Coach newsletter, which is where I will first announce when that course is available for you to get. All right, first off, this is just my preference. This is what I personally like. And I see a lot of my students that could benefit from using thicker paint. Now, thick paint just looks better. There's a certain look that thick paint has, like a richness, a juiciness. I just feel like you get the most bang for your buck out of oil paints when you actually use them thickly. All right, so I'm gonna start at the beginning here. And first off, beginner oil painters just do not put out enough paint. I know oil paint isn't cheap and you don't wanna waste it and you feel like you have leftover paint when you're done. But you have to put out more paint. If you don't put out enough paint, you're just not gonna use enough paint. It's just, you're just subconsciously not gonna pull as much paint out on your brush if it's not out there. So don't worry about wasting paint and get enough paint out onto your palette. Now, I feel that a lot of beginner oil painters are timid when it comes to thick paint. They're scared to use a lot of paint. They're scared to make bold strokes with thick paint. And the thing is when you use thick paint and do have bold brushwork, it shows confidence. It shows a level of decisiveness with your painting. And the thing is, beginners shouldn't be worried about using thick paint because it's actually easier to move and work around than thin paint. When you use thin paint, it gets absorbed pretty quickly into the canvas and you can't really work it around that much. With thick paint, once it's on there, you can push it around, you can pull it, you can add in other colors to change the color that's on there. And even if you don't like what you have on there at all, you can always take a palette knife and scrape it off and start again. Also, this way of working, of putting down thick paint, moving it around, pushing it around, taking it off if you need to, it's a good battle against formulaic painting. And all of this laying down paint and correcting and recorrecting can create a more interesting painting. If you look at a lot of the old masters' works like Sargent or Edgar Payne, Rembrandt, you're gonna see a lot of thick paint. Now, I know a lot of people say, oh, well, I'm scared to use thick paint because once I put it down, I'm not able to layer on top of it. My colors get muddied together. The problem with that is that you're not using thick enough paint, honestly. Now, granted, yeah, your initial layers of paint that you put down shouldn't be glopped on there with a palette knife. It should be decently, you know, thick and opaque, but you should have a little bit more room to build the thicker paint. And the reason that you can't layer paint on top of other wet paint is because you really just aren't laying down thick enough paint. I find even sometimes with myself as the painting goes on, I get a little bit lazy. The pools of paint on my palette are getting thinned out and I don't replenish the paint and I just start grabbing less and less paint on my brush and it becomes more difficult to do the things I want to do because I don't have enough paint on my brush. Now, another cool thing that you can do with thick paint that I actually don't do, but a lot of great artists do, I think Monet did this a lot, which is you can use broken color. I mean, if you have two different colors side by side, like really close together, you can see them separate, but when you stand back, your eyes kind of blend them together and they look like a different color. So if you had, you know, some spots of blue and some spots of yellow, when you stand back, they kind of mix together and look like a green. Now, another thing that you can do is you can have a variety of thin and thick paint on your painting. And having this dynamic just can make your painting more interesting. You got some passages that are thinner, some are thicker. And a lot of times you can use the thick paint to really sell something that's very sturdy, concrete, and a hard surface. Whereas thinner paint is more kind of airy and it will be used a lot for darks. You know, I do paint dark to light and thin to thick, so my lights do tend to be the thickest paint on my painting. And a perfect example of what I'm trying to talk about here is this lifeguard stand painting that I did. Most of the painting, it's not too thick. I mean, it's not thin or a wash or anything, but I definitely got a lot thicker and used a palette knife for the lit side of the red lifeguard stand and really just caked on the paint here because I really wanted to sell this effect of the light hitting it, and I really wanted it to pop. A cool thing when you lay down paint with a palette knife is you kind of push it to an extra value that you can't get when the paint's not really thick. Like once you hit that palette knife level where you're really laying on the paint really thick, which I do sometimes, I save it for the very end of my paintings. Once you do that, it can just kind of push things to a new level. Now, when I say thick paint, that means paint that isn't thinned out with either paint thinner or linseed oil. Don't get fat over lean confused with thin to thick. Fat over lean is just talking about how much medium is in your paint. You know, if it's fatter, it's gonna have more medium. But putting more medium into the paint is actually thinning it out. You know, you use enough linseed oil, your paint's gonna become transparent. It's not gonna become cakey and thick. And there is a time to use linseed oil there. I mean, there's a time to use a wash at the beginning of your painting. But I just feel that a lot of people lose their painting when it comes time to really lay on thick paint and not be afraid of it. I've talked about this a little bit before too, but you also got to make sure you have the right brushes to do this. If you're using watercolor brushes, acrylic brushes, or just like really soft synthetic brushes, those might be good for blending. They might be good for, you know, working thin paint, which does have its place in oil painting. And depending on the process you're doing, you might need different kind of brushes. You just really have to have good thick bristle brushes. Now they can be synthetic, they can be natural bristle brushes, whichever you want. I personally like to use Rosemary & Co's ivory synthetic brushes. I actually have a beginner's brush set. If you have no idea what brushes to get, I'll put a link to the video on that brush set above right now. Now, I've talked about this before, but one of my favorite oil painting books by Kevin McPherson suggests a painting exercise where you use a 9x12 canvas panel and then you squirt out entire tubes of paint onto your palette. So you squirt out, you know, entire tube of each of the primaries in white, and you paint a painting on that 9x12 panel, and you have to use all of the paint that you put out onto your panel. Now this is excessive and he's just trying to get a point across, but I think it says a lot to how important using thicker paint is. Now this is also very important for portraits. I get a lot of people asking me, how do I paint the portraits I do in my, you know, loose style but still looking by the like the person? And a lot of that does have to do with how much paint that I am using. If you actually want to know more about painting loose and how I paint loose, I've actually just made a video about that not too long ago. I'll put a link above to where you can go watch that. But when you have thick paint on there, especially for skin and just the feeling of skin, having that thick paint and pushing it around and moving it and building it up, it just, I feel like it just adds so much to the portrait as opposed to thinly painted portraits, because you get the full color, you get the full punch of oils, and just with skin, I just think it works great. So if you want to practice using thick paint, I highly suggest painting small. I mean, even if you only have big canvases or big canvas pad, tape it off to little 5 inch by 5 inch squares, you know, whatever dimensions you want, but work painting small and get a feel for that thick paint. Get used to it. Don't be scared of it. Lean into it. Make it do what you want it to do, and don't be afraid to go even thicker. Have confidence with your brushwork. Now, speaking on confidence with your brushwork, I always like to think of brushwork like paper mache. Like when I'm laying down a stroke, I'm thinking about as if my paint is paper mache and I'm wrapping it around the object. So when you're creating these bold strokes, think about the direction you're going in. You know, when I'm painting, my hand is all over the place to get the right angle. Sometimes I'm pulling my brush up, sometimes I'm pulling it down side to side. Whatever it is I need to do to really sell the form of the subject, because I know that my brushwork is gonna be very bold and noticeable, so I wanna make sure that it's doing the right thing. Now, painting with thick paint is gonna be uncomfortable at first, but trust me, as you practice and you get better at it, you're gonna like it so much more. You're gonna be glad that you stuck it out and got through the learning process and are able to control and manipulate this great thick paint the way you want to. All right, so that's what I have to say on using thick paint. Again, if you like this video, if you like the channel, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Link to my full tutorials on Patreon are in the description below. Also down there, the shortcut to color mixing guide. Sign up to that. Get subscribed to the Paint Coach newsletter so you don't miss out when I release my Foundations of Oil Painting course. And if you want to see what I am painting on a daily basis, you can follow me on Instagram at Forza43. I'm Chris Fornatero here telling you to go get painting. Congratulations, you made it to the end of the video. You win the prize of subscribing to this channel. Also, an extra surprise, this video right here.